Hi, this is AM with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about graphic design trends in 2019. So I really love all throughout the previous year just looking at the types of trends that are coming up and getting more and more dominant and gaining momentum. I think it's really fun to actually try to incorporate some of those into my own work. And I hope after viewing this video, you'll try to incorporate some into your own designs too. So we're going to go ahead and just jump right in. The first design trend is 3D. And the thing about 3D and the reason that I think it's so prominent right now is because of the design tools that have come around that have made it really easy for us designers to start playing around with 3D and trying our own things. So some of these would be like Adobe Dimension or Cinema 4D. And as designers, we always need to be looking at what new programs we need to learn. If you're not interested in learning one of these programs, you can still do a lot with Photoshop and Illustrator. I'm going to be showing a lot of examples of these trends, and you can see a little bit more about each artwork in my description, so just take a look at that if you get some time. This first one uses a lot of 3D elements that sort of have a nature feel. They use a lot of really bright colors to showcase the 3D, which actually looks very realistic. This next artist, she uses more muted tones and also throws some patterns into her 3D work, and I think it works really well. It's definitely a different take on it. In this last one, the artist is using the 3D trend and also taking it a step further by making it look like it's sort of balancing. The next trend I'm seeing a lot of is gradients. And this has been a trend for maybe a couple years already, but I think that we as artists have been pushing it more and more because of new tools that have been available to us. Like just this last year, Adobe came out with freeform gradients in Illustrator, and so that's been something that's made it even easier for designers to kind of use that trend easily. Let's take a look at some gradient examples now. Here are some illustrations where the gradients have been kind of put as a background and also used as shading. And this is a really interesting use of gradients. It makes it look really liquidy, even though that's just a gradient. That's all that's applied there. There are a lot of options to create some really interesting textures. And then this example shows how just adding some gradients can add some depth and character to your artwork. The third trend for 2019 is color. And by that I mean bright color. Neons, kind of soft fades into different colors. That kind of goes along with the gradient trend. Here's an example. This designer is using a lot of bright colors, and this is really kind of a big removal from the muted tones we saw a couple years ago. Back then, the 70s had sort of a renaissance, and we saw a lot of retro styles. And now we're seeing the next decade, which is 80s and 90s, come back around again. Here's another example of some really bright colors being used in a Tropicana package mockup. Using the different colors to sort of contrast with each other, and it really gives it a fresh and modern feel. Now another trend, if you want to call it that, is all three of these being used together. So gradient, 3D, and bright colors. And I expect a lot of that to come through this year. The fourth trend is video. Now this is something that has been sort of ramping up over the last couple years. People are turning to video to learn. They'd rather have someone show them rather than have them read it. So as designers, we're going to be getting a lot more requests for Facebook video, animation, explainer videos. So it's a really great idea to get into Premiere and After Effects and at least get your feet wet to start being able to use these trends when your clients request them. And I'm sure you've all seen the Facebook video ads that most companies are putting out now. This one's for the New York Times, and as you can see, they're really, really simple, and they're very, very short. But they're effective, they're clean, so these aren't going to take a lot of time, but you probably will need to learn how to use those programs. The fifth trend for 2019 is flowy liquids. So these can be in the form of a shape, or they can be inside text, or they can actually be like liquid pouring onto text or something like that. This example has a lot of bright colors and a lot of different flowy elements, and then they're also moving on top of that. So this designer actually is using quite a few of the trends we've been talking about. Here's an example of some liquid looking type where they use gradients to give that simulation. And I think it's really successful. And here's an example of that third option where liquid is just being poured onto something, in this case, a letter. And this is also utilizing the 3D component. The last 2019 trend is for illustration. Illustrators are now using a lot of different body types and different ethnicities in their illustrations. And I think this is just designers embracing diversity. In this day and age, I think most of us really focus on that in our designs because we want to be inclusive and our clients are demanding that. They want diversity in their ads and in their brochures and that kind of thing. This is a trend that's been going on for a while and I see really continuing. Now, there are a couple trends that have had their heyday and I kind of feel like they're on their way out. The first of these is low poly. And here are some examples of that. So these are like the fractal breaking apart of images and then shading them in the same way. So these really were popular, I would say, last year and a couple years ago, but I think they are going to really start going out of style now in 2019. Okay, and another trend that I see that's kind of on the way out is bokeh. Here are a few examples of bokeh. They're those little points of light that kind of shimmer in the background. And the reason I'm seeing these as going out of style is because they're so generic. They are not tailored to an audience. I think they worked fine for a while, but we as designers need to be focusing more on our end user. And our clients have seen this kind of bokeh style with text over it 1,000 times before. So I think this year you'll see a huge decline in the amount of times these get used. So those are my 6 graphic design trends and 2 trends that are not happening in 2019. If you think I've left any out or if you agree or disagree on some of these, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And I'll talk to you next Thursday with another graphic design video. Thank you.